Coming up on Mountain News this morning, we are following a developing story out of Washington as tensions between the United States and Iran continue to rise. And back here at home, at least one person has lost their home as rain in Pike County continues to leave devastation in its path through damaging floodwaters. Plus, police in Laurel County responded to a rescue call, becoming part of an unexpected flood recovery effort in the process.
Dedicated to Eastern and Southern Kentucky, this is WYMT Mountain News This Morning.
Good morning. It is 4:59 on Friday, June the 21st. I'm Will Puckett. Thank you for tuning in to Mountain News This Morning. Well, we have less than 12 hours until it is officially summer, and today we finally start getting a feel of what summer might be like. No rain today, which is the good thing, but it's not completely out of the forecast. Let's bring Brandon in this morning and give you a better breakdown of what to expect on this Friday. Brandon, good morning.
Good morning. In less than 7 hours until summer arrives, 11:54 this morning, but right now this morning, we are quiet after a very active pattern. Let's go to live pinpoint Doppler radar where you see clean sweeps for the first time in a long time. But as Will alluded to, it's not going to last. Temperatures across the region in the 50s and 60s. When you walk out the door this morning, it's going to feel less humid too, thanks to the passage of that front. So a few degrees cooler in some locations this morning, 11 degrees cooler than it was this time yesterday in Monticello, 2, 3, 6 degrees there in a lot of other locations. So your out the door forecast, a few clouds this morning, then mostly sunny skies, but again, we're not out of the woods yet. I'll talk more about the full forecast coming up here in just a few minutes. Will.
All righty, Brandon. Thank you. Well, this morning we start off with a CBS News that has confirmed that President Trump signed off on a plan last night to conduct a limited airstrike against Iranian assets before an apparent change of heart caused the operation to be called off. Sources with the administration say the order to stand down came after preparations for the attack were already underway. Word on the attack had been in the works, as it came from the White House, and Tehran exchanged accusations over the downing of an American drone in the Strait of Hormuz. At one point Thursday, President Trump appeared to give Iran benefit of the doubt.
I find it hard to believe it was intentional, if you want to know the truth. I think that it could have been somebody who was loose and stupid that did it.
Now, some Democrats say more needs to be done to de-escalate the situation. The United Nations issued a statement urging all parties to exercise maximum restraint and avoid doing anything that could inflame the situation. Well, floodwaters can quickly become a threat to core. Perry County Extension Agent Charles May and a local gardener tell the YMT's Taylor Upchurch that to look out for what the floods for the fields as flooding continues here in Kentucky.
With spring comes rain showers and fears of flooded crops.
As we couldn't have the crops without the rain, but it also creates a lot of problem when you can't get in there to work your crops.
Agriculture agents like Charles May say to resist temptation. If the ground is wet, try to stay out of the fields.
You ruin the soil structure basically by walking in there, compaction and all that. So we definitely need to stay out of them to get dry enough. So that means, you know, you're not going to be cultivating. Weed control is going to be done by hand for a while.
Water flow can cause contamination, meaning if your fruits and vegetables are underwater, throw them out. James Combs says farmable land is hard to find in eastern Kentucky. He feels for those who plant to sell and are forced to throw it away.
It's their livelihood. They're losing money every time they can't get in there to gather their crops.
Wet weather leads to poor pollination, and humidity causes bacteria to grow. But when it rains, any spray used to kill fungus becomes a waste.
You spray this morning and it rains this afternoon, that doesn't do very much good.
Though the cons seem to outweigh the pros, they're still happier to see a downpour than a drought. In Perry County, Taylor Upchurch, WYMT Mountain News.
Now, ag specialists say contamination is caused by more than water. If bacteria is growing in your garden, be aware that walking through rows of damp crops could spread diseases. Well, flooding in Pike County Wednesday evening resulted in one woman losing the place she calls home. Water rose over the roadway on Stillhouse Avenue in Elkhorn City, closing off the road for a while and ultimately damaging a home. Connie Hill, the renter, says she left home to wait out the rain and came back to see a devastating scene.
Then last night I was gone, If I was God, it'd come at real bad rain. And then it flooded probably about 2 foot in the house.
Hill says she lost a lot of her personal items and furniture, but she feels blessed to have gotten out unharmed. Crews in Laurel County responded to a call yesterday. They thought it was a rescue mission as they received reports of a car stuck in high water. But when they got there, they discovered the car had been abandoned. The driver apparently had tried to drive through high water, but got stuck and then left the vehicle. The car was later towed out of the water. Well, we are still waiting for an update on almost a dozen lost hikers at the Red River Gorge. We first told you about this yesterday. The Pinal County Search and Rescue Team says the hikers were dropped off Wednesday night. No one has heard from them since. Crews are searching in the Gray's Arch Trail area. Well, if things continue to look like this, Western Michigan football players may have to find another place to practice. This is their stadium, several inches underwater. The facility's management team has already started to get the water off of the field and will let most of it drain naturally. The National Weather Service has issued a flood advisory for the area until 11 a.m. today. Well, thank you for getting your day started with us right here on Mountain News this morning. Say cheese. June 21st is National Selfie Day. We will have more on the surprisingly long history of the trend.
Summer is only hours away, and thankfully it looks like we're welcoming it in a drier forecast, at least for today. I have the details in about 3 minutes.